We would like to thank every one of you for being here with us this morning. Thank you for your comfort and for your support.
A little further.
Okay. That's it. Okay. Okay. Should I go ahead? Okay. A famous writer once said, "We make a living by what we get. We make a life by what we give." If this is true, then Ava Maria Roy lived a great life. She was the most giving person, and judging from the nodding heads, it seems that many of you agree. Ava Maria Charles was born February 6, 1957, in St. Anne's, Port of Spain, Trinidad, to Geraldine L. Sidney and Adolphus Mano Charles, both deceased. She attended Belmont Seventh-day Adventist School, then furthered her education by attending Ugles Commercial School, where she obtained her degree in clerical studies. Ava was always an extremely hardworking individual who always made her kids a priority. Ava believed deeply in the Word of God. She was a strong mother, humble, and always sacrificed herself for her family and friends. Ava, Avi as we know her, most of us, was very active in her family circle and was known for fun, family gatherings, and always ready with a positive outlook and attitude, making herself available to help others. May she rest in God's loving arms. Again, on behalf of the family, we want to thank you all for being here with us today. We really appreciate it. Thank you.
Do we have any other eulogies? Any other eulogies? Any other tributes? Is any? There's one more? Okay.
I would like to begin by saying thank you to everyone for being here. Our grandmother, Ava Roy, was a teacher, a caregiver, and above all, a great grandmother. For all those who knew her, knew she loved her family, her children, her grandchildren, and her significant other, Mr. Ronald John, who loved her dearly. She had a special place in her heart for her grandchildren. We learned a lot from her, especially housekeeping and waking up on time for chores. One thing for sure is her house was always clean. It had nothing like sleeping in. She taught us to wake up on time, do what we have to do, and then relax. I remember the days when school was closed. We all spent time down the road. Granny was always saying that she couldn't wait for school to open back. Whenever we disagree with each other, she would quarrel and tell us, "Go in all the father rooms until they come home." Little Isaiah even made up a song for her whenever she was quarreling, "Come down from the granny." She laughed every time she heard him sing it, and he would never stop singing it. We all had our ups and downs, but at the end of the day, it was only love. Up to this day, I could be passing through the living room and I would still hear Granny saying, "Why these children don't listen?" If you heard her voice raise, you know you, and you hear her, "Oh gosh, man, just know she's about to blow." She never played about her living room. My favorite day was Sundays by Granny. Granny would cook that kalaloo, pilau, coleslaw, tuna pasta, some of her favorite meals from her. When it was time to go, everyone would pack a bowl of food to carry to school on Monday. If you know my grandmother, you'd know she loved to get her hair and her toes done. Once it wasn't pink though, she didn't like that color at all. She loved to dress up. She was obsessed with perfume, which Auntie Shelley made sure and spoiled her with. Yes, it's a sad moment, but Granny was the life of the party, especially when she had a bear in her hand. Even though two bears were a limit, party done and waste like first time. Mind you, once she told you she was coming back just now, that meant we will see her the next morning. Our grandmother taught us how to live in a world where we have to work for what we want. Because as she used to say, nobody will give you anything out here. And if they do, it may be with a bad eye or with the intentions of giving back something in return. She fought her battles in life so that her children and grandchildren will not have a life like she did. We were always told to do better, aim for more, and be successful in this life. No one person is perfect, and we all have our shortcomings, but if we didn't have them, our family wouldn't be our family. We feel so much emotions just like everyone else right now, but we won't allow it to overwhelm us. We have to come to peace with it because despite our feelings, God is always the master orchestra. The same way he let the storm pass our way is the same way he's going to comfort us and guide us through it. We know you loved us, and we will always love you, Granny. Although this suddenness left us with so much left unsaid, we'll hold on to the love that we share with you. God had better plans for her, and I know she will always be here in spirit looking down at us. I hope that my family will be able to stay strong for each other and continue to live in love. Ava Marie Roy, sunrise February 6, 1957, to sunset July 1st, 2022. You will be missed by all of us. Continue sleeping in peace, my angel. Your legacy will always live on. Sincerely, your grandchildren.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In the waters of baptism, Ava died with Christ and rose with him to new life. may she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Ava, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated for our readings.
Good morning. John saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth had disappeared. Now, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city and the new Jerusalem coming down from God out of heaven, as beautiful as a bride all dressed for her husband. Then I heard a loud voice call from the throne, "You see this city?" Question. Here God lives among men. He will make his home among them. They shall be his people, and he will be their God. His name is God with them. He will wipe away all their tears from their eyes. There will be no more death, and no more mourning of sadness. The world of the past has gone. Then the one sitting on the throne spoke, "Now I am making the whole of creation new," he said. "I will give water from the well of life, free to anybody who is thirsty. It is the rightful inheritance of the one who proves victorious, and I will be his God, and he is son to me." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
A man in the crowd said to Jesus, "Master, tell my brother to give me a share of our inheritance." "My friend," he replied, "who appointed me your judge or the arbitrator of your claims?" Then he said to them, "Watch and be on your guard against avarice of any kind, for a man's life is not made secure by what he owns, even when he has more than he needs." Then he told them a parable. There was once a rich man who, having had a good harvest from his land, thought to himself, "What am I to do? I have not enough room to store my crops." Then he said, "This is what I will do. I will pull down my barns and build bigger ones, and store all my grain and my goods in them. And I will say to my soul, you have plenty of good things laid by for many years to come. Take things easy, eat, drink, have a good time." But God said to him, "Fool, this very night the demand will be made for your soul. And this hoard of yours, whose will it be then?" So it is when a man stores up treasure for himself in place of making himself rich in the sight of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated for a short while. In our gospel parable, Jesus said, "This night the demand, a demand for your soul will be made." And I think that is very important, especially when we celebrate services like this, when we celebrate the lives that people have lived while here, and now they have gone to their Maker, God. Because we don't know when that night will be. None of us knows that, when our night will come and God will make a demand on our soul. In other words, this will be my last day on earth. No one knows that. Only God knows that. And that is why it is so important that before that demand is made for our souls by God, we put things right and we live a life according to heaven and how God wants us to live. Because for many people, sometimes when that demand is made for our souls, for many people we find ourselves not ready to go home. We must always be ready to go back to our God. Always. And we ready ourselves by the way we live according to God's commandments, by the way we pray, and how we worship our God. Unless we do that, we'll be in grave danger. And this is a great opportunity, as Ava has gone home to her Father in heaven, for all of us, for all of us to take stock of our lives and ask ourselves that very important question. If a demand is made for my soul now, am I ready? That question, I think, should always be on the forefront of our minds, because that is the question that will guide us in the way we live in this life. It is very easy, as Jesus shows in the gospel, to store treasures in this earth, in this life, and not to store treasure in heaven. It is very easy to work and to toil endless hours a day, to accumulate, to hoard, to make ourselves rich in the sight of this world. It's very easy to do that.
and forget about making ourselves rich in the sight of God. And the sad part about all this is that when we die, all that we work for so hard, we take night to make day, we labor endlessly to accumulate and to save. When we die, we take nothing with us. Someone else comes and they enjoy the fruits of our hard toil and labor. That is the reality of life. So yes, make the most out of this life. Whatever we work, how hard we work, enjoy it. That is God's gift to us. We don't hoard, we don't save, but we enjoy everything that God has given to us and make the most out of this life. And making the most out of this life doesn't necessarily have to be spending lavishly on things and wasting things. Making the most out of this life has a lot to do with the way we live with one another. Sometimes we find ourselves in petty quarrels, family feuds, we're fighting one another, we can't forgive one another. To make the most out of life is to live in good relationship with one another. As soon as something happens, to work towards peace and harmony, to work towards forgiveness. Because we don't know when God will ask for our souls back, to come back to Him. To make the most out of this life is to be ready and prepared for that day. So I ask again, if God comes now and asks for our souls, are we ready? Would we go willingly back to God? Thanks be to God. He's a merciful God. And He gives us so many chances and opportunities to make things right. We need to make use and to be grateful of these opportunities. My friends, none of us, no one in this world belong to themselves. No one. It's sad to say, and it is a fact. Not even your children, not even the children of Ava really belong to her. Each one of us belong to God. We are all God's children. And one day, God will call us back to Himself. It might be a very sad time for those left behind, I admit, because we get used to one another. We build friendships, we build relationships, so now when it's time to give back what belongs to God, it's so difficult for us. But if we live a life being ready and being prepared for that day, we'll always be reminded that one day I have to let go. I need to let go. We'll always be mindful that none of us, not even my children, belong really to me. They are God's children. They are on loan to me. All of us here are on loan. And the time will come when God will want back what is His. And I think that's something beautiful. When God takes back what is His. Because everything that belongs to God is holy. Everything and everyone that belongs to God is a holy person and a blameless person. Everyone that belongs to God is a saint. And if God wants us back in heaven to be saints, yes, in the midst of our sadness and our grief, I believe that's something we can all be grateful for. Ava has gone home to her Father in heaven. That doesn't mean she has left us. It doesn't. Ava can now be more of a mother than she was when she was in this life. Let me say that again. Ava now can be more of a mother than when she was living in this life. Because when she was alive, she was limited with time and space. She couldn't be all over at the same time in this life. Sorry about that, these little intrusion tend to make me lose my focus. Ava is more of a mother now than she was in this life. In this life, she couldn't be all over at the same time. In this life, she didn't have the power that she has now of intercession, of praying for her children, now that she is numbered among the saints. In this life, she wasn't as close to God. None of us are close to God in this life as the saints are now close to God. And that's why she can be more of a mother, because now Ava is closer to God than she will ever be. Now as a mother, she can pray and intercede for her children. Now as a mother, she can be with her children anywhere they are at any given time. So she is more of a mother now than when she was in this life. And that's something I really believe we need to be mindful of, because it brings hope. It brings hope that now Ava, even though we may not see her in physical form, it doesn't mean she's not there. We don't see the saints, but they are here with us. We don't see our Blessed Mother, but she is here with us. We don't see our Lord in body, but he is here with us. And he's not only here with us, he's all over at the same time. And that is how Ava will be now. Death is not the end. Huh? Death is not final. It feels final, but it will never be final. Death is simply a doorway to heaven. And heaven is where all of us want to go. It's where Ava wanted to go. You want to go to heaven. I want to go to heaven. But in order to go to heaven, we have to leave this life. So we have to take that choice now, to leave this life and to leave it well. That's the only way we can get to heaven. So now Ava has entered into heaven as she has left us in this life. Now, my friends, she can look over you, she can pray for you, and she can be with you at any given time, in any given place. She doesn't have to jump on a plane and go to visit now. She doesn't have to do that anymore. Now she can be where her other children are, perhaps in other countries, and she can be with her family in this country at the same time. So let us keep that in mind. Let us remember that. Now, Ava is not dead. Death is too final of a word. Ava continues to live. And she continues to live in heaven. And one day, we will all be united with Ava in heaven. That home where we all belong. None of us belong in this world. None of us. As much as you, it's difficult to hear, no one belongs in this world. We all belong to heaven. And one day, we will be reunited with Ava, our mother, our sister, our aunt, our grandmother, in heaven, where we'll all be happy, where we'll all be saints, we'll all be singing, we'll all be rejoicing. Please stand as you offer our prayer. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and deceased. For offering baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that you may now be admitted to the company of saints in heaven. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for Ava, who had the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day. Lord, hear us. We pray for all our friends, our relatives, and our benefactors, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, hear us. We pray for those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, hear us. We pray for the family and friends of Ava, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, hear us. We pray for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, hear us. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for Ava. Cleanse her of her sins and grant her the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for our offertory.
For our offertory collection song, we will do the tribute song, In the Arms of an Angel. That you fear, you are cool from
Please stand as we now pray the words our Savior gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Lord God, give of peace and heal of souls. Hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
To you, Lord, we commend the soul of Ava, your servant, in the sight of this world. She is now dead, but in your sight she lives forever. Forgive whatever sins she may have committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Because God has chosen to call Ava from this life to himself, we commit her body to the earth, to its final resting place, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend Ava to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise up her body on the last day. Please be seated for the final rites. And ask for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto Ava, O Lord.
Let perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
And may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Amen. Ava Maria Roy, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and lead you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham and where Lazarus is born no longer. Ava, may you find eternal rest. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain forever.
Amen.
Let us now go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Before we proceed with the cassette, we have a short video presentation and an introduction by Shalyan before that.
Good morning, everyone. From the very first time I met Ava, we clicked. And until her last day, our bond remained close because Ava's personality exuded that of joy and love. I loved Ava, and I will miss her dearly. I wish I had more time than this short time to say all the things my heart feels. The one thing I'm sure she knew is that I loved her. The sting of death is never easy, but I know someday we will meet again in that great land. Death may be a tragedy, but when one dies in Christ, it's a victory. Memories may fade over time, but the love I have for my sister isn't a memory, she's a part of me. Angels are sisters that has moved far away. A bit of you will always be with me. Sleep on, my love, until that trumpet sounds and we meet again.
Hello all, my name is Irene, for those of you who don't know me, also known as Miss I. I'll either have to try to forgive me in advance because I'm going to try to get through this without crying, but Ava Roy, fondly known as Avi by myself and many others, she was like a mother to me. She always used to say, sometimes family is more than by blood. Family is how people treat you, how they make you feel, and how they take you in. And you know, they say some people have a Bible and they read their Bible, but they don't live by the Bible. She was not that person. She walked in the way of the Lord, and she treated everyone as though they were family. And because of that, she and I became very close, and I would refer to her as my mom. It helped that her daughter and I were the best of friends, and that her granddaughter is also my goddaughter. But it was truly through the way she treated me and she treated others that came to make me love her. So she gave herself so selflessly, so freely to others. I mean, she would come and see me every time she would come to the States, and she would stay with me, and her mind was always on helping everyone else. She was always set to, oh, I want to buy books, I want to help to buy clothes. She always had her family on her mind. She held them very dear. And for that, it made it easy to love her because she was just such a selfless and pure person. And again, for that, there was nothing I wouldn't do for her because of how she treated me and how she treated others. And for that, she will always be loved. She will never be forgotten, and she will always be missed because she touched my life and the lives of so many, to the point where my son refers to her as Granny Abby. And that in itself should speak volumes, because we were not blood, but we became that close. And so I have to take solace, all of us have to take solace in knowing that she is in a better place among the rest of the angels where she belongs.
It's Irene, for those of you who don't know.
There's one more song on the program that I would just like to do a little bit of, because you cannot help but notice that her name, Ava Maria, is just one letter different from Ave Maria. And that's one of the songs in the program, and because of her name, we have to do that. So there's a little bit of Ave Maria. And we will navigate the casket back down. Please join me in our recessional song, How Great Thou Art. O Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars.